Some people sit down at the table and don't even give thanks. They just sit down and eat privileges in their own mind. Here we are at the last supper with 12 apostles and others gathered around the table. Where do we go from here? We come to God's table for guidance, forgiveness, for love, for wisdom, and Holy Ghost power. Order. We ask God to search us, teach us, renew us when we come to his table. It's something about the gathering and fellowshipping with one another that ignites confidence and strength. It's something about getting on one accord with God. Everything else seems to fall in line. I'm glad, church, when I fall down on my knees and Jesus sees my shortcomings and he knows exactly what I need, when I need it, and how I need it, he provides for me. When it seems like trouble on every side, he sends peace. You see, God sends his angels to come see us. God said, take me with you. Put me down on the inside so that when trouble comes, you can pull from within. For God so loved the world. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that everyone who believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. I tell you, when it comes to this table, for God didn't send his Son into the world to condemn it, but to save the world. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he believed not in the name of God. I heard someone say, you better eat your food before I get caught. We are at the last supper. Jesus instructed his disciples how to carry on, so that we may have a life and have it abundantly. Are you full yet? Do you have room for more? Communion Sunday is a chance where we reflect on what God has done for each one of us and to renew the covenant that he has with us. We do this in remembrance of him. Jesus the Christ. Jesus the Christ made the promise to be present through his holy sacrament of the Eucharist, to be with those who partake in it. Where do we go when the issues of life overcome us? We go to God. Do you remember where God has brought you from? Think about that for a second. Do you remember? There used to be a time where I would sit on the porch on Sunday morning and look at other folk going to church. They clubbed the night before. Yeah, I ain't always had a suit on. But I began to see the peace and the joy Yeah, Brother Moss, I see you with so-and-so just after you left. There was trouble on all sides. Yeah, Brother Moss, I see you with so-and-so. You know me again. Do you remember what God has brought you from? Do you remember the blessings God sent your way? God said, I heard your prayer. I'm waiting for you to come to my table. Bring your plate with you. It's already been made. This plate that I'm going to give you is packed with power. It's packed with discernment. It's packed with wisdom. It's packed with the Holy Spirit. Come and partake of the table that's been made. And when you come to the table, come expecting change there. Come expecting God to do a new thing in you and around you. Well, do we go from here? Taking part in Holy Communion allows us to renew our relationship with God. With praying and fasting and allowing God to come inside your heart, make me new, God. Do a new thing inside of me. Teach me, oh Lord, how to worship. Teach me, O Lord, how to honor you. Paul was telling the church to walk in a newness of life, to be strong in our Lord, to be of good courage. Put your trust in the Lord. Stand firm against the enemy, for God is with thee always. Let nothing stand before you. God says, I'm the author and the finisher. Put God's word down on the inside so that you may be able to speak and see those things are yet to come. Put on my covering, my armor, my body, which is broken for you. Forever walk with me so I can guide thee. Pray unto me so I can hear you. Partake of my spirit that will dwell on the inside. Come get a plate of the soul food. I guarantee you, you won't walk away home. When the enemy tries to steal, kill, and destroy, God has already prepared a seat for the strength. With everyone today that is fed up with trying to figure it out yourself, one that is hungry for the word of God, one with no church home, not under the watchful care of a pastor. Where do we go from here is the question this morning. And God already has the answers. With everyone,